The students who come to learn Welsh in our residential course are all ages, all nationalities, and from all walks of life. Apart from Welsh students, we've got, well, Patagonian, of course. They get a bursary as our only colony.
Oops, everything's falling apart here.
Very, very tight. Kiwi, that's New Zealanders to you and me. Russian, American, Dutch. So if we move on now.
Which is the verb?
Icelandic, yeah, that's it. They've all got different reasons for putting on the D plates, being dysgwyr, as we say in Welsh.
Because I do need it, really. I said I need it like Jennifer Aniston needs A-list sperm before eggs go off. I provide a service, see, and that service should be bilingual, really, shouldn't it? You can't spread the fun if you ain't got the tongue.
Seriously, how could you be a vicar? No, no, Ashley.
So, Thori, why are you learning to speak Welsh? Somebody there for work. One chap wants to learn so he can propose to his Welsh-speaking fiancé.
I know why I'm doing it. I'm from Merthyr. It's my native language, my heritage, tongue of my ancestors, all that bollocks, and the fact that I can't speak it, right, is, well, you know, it's not only wrong, right, it's totally f***ing.
The course is 6 weeks long, and we try to replicate real-life, day-to-day situations.
I like coffee. Malcolm, wyt ti'n hoffi coffee?
Nah.
Ydw. Dwi yn hoffi coffee. The answer would be ydw, Malcolm. Do you like coffee?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I do. Yeah, that would be the correct answer then. I do. Excellent. I do. My, right, my Malcolm. My Malcolm. Un.
There are lectures, recreational events, lots of social interaction.
Was that your wife?
No, my wife's a lesbian.
A lot of them, you see, forge intense relationships on this course, which last for years. Life.
Coffee. My Malcolm and Hoffy coffee.
Dween. Dween. De Hoffy D.
Da.
Was that a Welsh for good or Russian for yes?
Nadia. She's an enigma, isn't she? Why a Russian woman would want to speak Welsh before she can even speak English is beyond me.
If you don't do it now...
Yeah, OK.
Yeah?
Dutch courage.
What?
Dutch courage, we call it.
It's the fault of public home. It was on the Dutch TV, and I don't know, I just started to watch, and I was like, wow, you know, what is this language? You know, it's really, I don't know, like Lord of the Rings or something, you know, I just had to learn it. So maybe, you know, after this course, if I can find some fairies, I can speak to them.
Some want to connect with their roots, others do it for fun, or for the love of learning languages.
Frying pan scar to guard.
scatter.
Yeah, that's what my parents got me for Christmas this year.
Richard! Sharad Kamrad.
Yes, fair to us now.
Translate that.
Gas e posh.
She had.
Yes, I've said that before. I've said she's loaded. You can tell by her clothes, can't you? She's very well maintained.
Maybe she got from an admirer.
Oh my.
Yes.
It's international, cross-cultural, transcendental. No, I don't mean that way. I mean transcending borders. That's it. Yeah.
Listen, I've just got to,
Yeah. Learning a shared language is a wonderful thing. A bonding experience. Come in. Like Bostick.